Hey guys, spoiler alert, this is in the Aaron Conscious Diesel surprise box. All right, so I spoiled you all. So, this is a vision notebook, and it's for if you're into vision boards. I am not a person who does vision boards, that means cutting out things, and I just don't do it. It's just not me. So, I was like, what can I use this for? What can I use this for? And I decided to cross out vision and put in goals, which makes the most sense. So if you're a person where you're stuck on what to use this for, you can basically use it for what I'm using it for, and that's goals. So when you open it up, it says reflection right here, and I just put what has happened in the last 3 months. I focused on this year. I didn't focus so much on what happened last year because it doesn't matter. So what happened in the past 3 months, I just went, put that me and my family went to Tokyo, and it says what I'm proud of the past 3 months, fix my issues with my non-weight loss, and so I reflected on that. And then you have this like, what would you like to improve on from the past? And I did put 6 months because the reason why I went back 6 months is so, because 6 months is a long time to notice something that's not happening, and 3 months is kind of where you're just trying to see what's going on. So what I would like to improve on is like not depending on the scale so much. The scale is a good reference number, but now I've started measuring how much weight I lose. So that is a better way for me to determine. Not that I don't care what this number says, because if it goes up, then I'm just like, why? But anyway, and so I put what is happening in my life right now, and I put the date and I put the word. I don't want to use it because I don't want to get flagged, but we all know what's going on. And so, and I put what I like about my life right now. Listen, I was gonna do a video on this, the pros and cons of being at home. I don't have to go anywhere. I don't have to deal with people. It just, there for an introvert like me who hates leaving the house, this is another day for me. And so I just put like, what do I like to improve on right now? Procrastination. I'm a big procrastinator. I am. I just, it's always, I'll do it tomorrow. My husband could probably tell that. It's always tomorrow with you. But I want to improve on it. So there's a page right here that says getting clarity, and it says what I want to focus on with my vision or vision. I put goals. And I put the things that I really want to focus on. I want to have more consistency with my face routine, working out, 5 to 6 days a week. No less than five. None. No less than five. But consistency, and I put out why. Same as my face routine. Consistency, if you're consistent with anything that you do, it'll just be like second nature. And then I put gardening, and I started a garden in my backyard. I am growing onions, carrots, and cantaloupe right now, and everything is sprouting, so it's good. And so right here says what I want to create with my, I just put goals, a consistent routine to establish better results. If you have a consistent routine, you get better results. It's common sense, which is not so common these days. So I put the goals that were important to me: stay on top of my meds, protecting my mental health, being emotionally available. I'm a person where it's very, I'll just shut off and I don't care about your feelings. I only care about three people, well, four people's feelings essentially. Anybody else, I really don't care. Sticking with my workouts, working hard on whatever it is I do. That's everything in my life, no matter how big or small. Having a clean and organized, calm house. Look, y'all made fun of me for having a clean house and always cleaning, and look what y'all doing right now. This is something I do every day. And less procrastination. So, you have this right here, this page, getting started on creating your vision, putting your vision, everything is vision, vision, vision. Brainstorming. I don't need to brainstorm anything because I pretty much know what I want to do. So you have these pages right here, and for my goals, I was using the soft bound, vertical, colorful Erin Condren planner that was sent to me. And while it worked better than the previous that one that I was using. I don't really need to look at it on a daily basis and focus on that one thing. As long as I'm doing something that can contribute to everything that I want to do every single day, it's fine. Another reason why I like this, nothing is dated, so it's always a reference point. I don't have to worry about getting a new planner. I can always go back to it, and there's quite a few pages in here, way more than I need right now, but I can always add to it at a later date. So you have these pages for brainstorming if that's what you want to do. And right here, this says your business, so you can like put quotes or pictures. I don't need to do that. So I just put, like I said, I just crossed out vision and put goals. And I put my goal for always taking my medication. I put when it was created and when I inputted it. And I put what this goal means to me. It says my moods will be more stabilized, which means I'm physically and mentally a better person. And because when I'm mentally good, I'm physically good. Like, I've been really good on my anxiety has been really, really high, which means I have a shit ton of energy. So that means I burn a ton of calories when I'm working out. That's the only good thing about being anxious, is that my resting heart rate is high, which means when I'm working out, it's even higher. So it means I can focus more clearly on everything I need to focus on. When I'm continuing to take my medication, it means I can focus more clearly. That's what that means. And then plans and action, you know, take my meds every day before I notice a mood shift. It's better for me personally to take it before I notice, because the mood has already changed. Once the mood has already changed, it's hard to get it back to what it was before. So it's better for me to take it early enough. And this brings consistency to and removes procrastination. So all of my goals are kind of intertwined. They all, you know, it's like 6 degrees of separation or something like that. And so I have this for procrastination and what that goal means to me. And then I have this one for working out. So I have a page for every single one of my things I want to focus on, which is great, because I have enough space where if I do want to add on to it, for say I'm like, oh, let me input that. I have the space, and then I have the space over here. And also every page. So I'm not trying to fill it up. It's just straight to the point, matter of fact, but I can add to it if I need to. And so this one right here, then I have organization. I filled that out yesterday. I left a page blank. I didn't want to go all in because I wanted to fill it out for you guys. So I put, we're going to do gardening today, because I haven't put that in here yet. So I'm just going to take my pen, which is Simply Gilded, by the way, if you guys are wondering. And I'm just going to cross out all this vision stuff and write goal. I think for me, goals are just better because I don't need to actually visually see it, you know, in a plan or anything like that. As long as it's written and I follow it, it's up to me to follow it. Nobody else. So my goal for gardening, and I want to say this started, it was March 1st or something like that. No, it was before that. I would say mid-February, so I'll just put 2/15/20. And when I'm putting it in here is, what is today? The 25th and 20. Okay. What this goal means to me means I can grow. I can grow veggies and fruits in my backyard. This also means spending less money at the grocery store. Spending less money at grocery store. Also, what does it mean? Does it mean anything else? That's what it is. Growing my own stuff, spending less money. Actually healthier, because you're growing it, you know. I'm not a person who cares about things being sprayed when they're being grown on farms or whatever. But since you're growing it, you know what you're putting into it. So it's a quote-unquote healthier. Health is a relative word, so I'll put that in quotes. Healthier for you. I'll just put for me, because I'm not talking to anybody else. All right, so that's basically it. And if I want to add on to it, I easily can. And so I'm going to put plans and actions to bring this goal to life. Buying supplies. Watering. Checking on plants. And researching. I did some researching before starting my garden. I wanted to see what I could plant right away. And a lot of vegetables you can't plant right away outside. They'll tell you to keep it in the house. I don't want to have to deal with all this stuff being in the house. So I got some plants that I can do right away. But it also depends on where you live. Since I live in basically like a desert, I live in a very hot climate for like 9 months out of the year, so I probably could get away with planting anything outside. The reason they tell you with a lot of plants to plant inside is because a lot of cities are cold, and so your plants can't take it being cold from seed form. So that's why. But I got my most recent plants in the seed form. I got the onions in the bulbs, and I got the carrots in seed form and the cantaloupe in seed form. The next time I buy plants, I will get them already sprouted, which I'm gonna do herbs. So that took researching. So I have to continue to do that when I buy new plants. That's basically it when it comes to me writing these goals down. And there's a ton of pages in here. Let's see what's in here. So you have a bunch of blank pages, which I showed in the video when I did the unboxing of this. So you get a bunch of blank pages, you get a bunch of notes, you get a bunch of dot grid. And then before that, there are a bunch of still vision goal pages. And so I have all of this. And that's pretty much what I'm working on right now. I'm pretty sure I'll think of something else because I have nothing but time right now that I will want to put in here. But that's what you can use this for if you don't want to use a vision board. Right now is a really, really good time to start a new goal or focus on your goals because a lot of us are at home. A lot of us hopefully are staying indoors and not leaving too much. So this is the time. You can even use this if you want to start like a new craft or start new hobbies. You can do that. But I just wanted to show you guys what you can use this for other than what its intended purpose is. I've seen people say they are just going to use this for a regular notebook and decorate. I have notebooks already. I don't need to do that. I don't want to waste washi tape and stickers on this. I'd rather just use it for its intended purpose, but cross out one word and make it another. So yeah. There you go. I'm gonna get out of here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it informative. I hope you guys are staying safe and quarantining, practicing social distancing physically. Still talk to your people on the phone or whatever. And yeah, take care of your mental health and your physical health. And I will see you all next time. Bye.